In order to measure distances, we use a metric. You have probably learned that in school, but without noticing. Imagine a problem like this. We want to calculate the distance between the points A and B. Let's call it S. By the Pythagorean theorem, this is the square root of 3 squared plus 4 squared, which equals 5. Square root, squaring, adding, this is kind of a peculiar formula. Let's generalize this. The distance between the origin and the point in space, let's call it x, is given by the length of this vector. The length of a vector is defined to be the square root of the inner product with itself. And an inner product is, for our purposes in this vector space, defined to be the vector times the metric times the vector. In index notation, we can write this as xi, gij, xj. In Euclidean space, that is flat space, the metric looks like this, where the first row and column corresponds to x, and the second row and column corresponds to y. And our vector x from the previous example reads 3, 4. If we write out this inner product, we see that certain terms vanish because of the metric. This leaves us with the same value as before, 5. Now let's switch to Minkowski space. Here we have a new metric, denoted by the Greek letter eta. It looks like this, where the first row and column is connected to time and the others to space. In order to remember that we now use this metric, we'll also use Greek letters for our indices later on. The negative signs have profound consequences when it comes to measuring distances. Let's use one time coordinate and one space coordinate for simplicity. Then the metric looks like this. If we calculate the inner product of x with itself, we get t squared minus x squared. Now depending on whether t or x is greater, we can have positive or negative values as well as zero. If, for a vector x, the time component is greater, we call this vector time-like. If the spatial component is greater, space-like. And if the inner product is zero, we call it light-like, because that means x equals t, which describes the motion of light. These concepts are really important when we talk about causality, so keep them in mind. But that's pretty much it for this time. Thanks for watching and see you next time.